Welcome to Victory Fellowship Church online service. Thank you for joining us today. For those that are joining us for the very first time, we welcome you. We love you, we appreciate you, and you're most welcome to join the Victory Fellowship family. For our family members, remember to share this message with everybody. Share the link to your friends, your neighbors, your workmates, so that the Word of God reaches far and far beyond. At Victory Fellowship, we believe in rooting, grounding, and establishing you in the Word of God. And today, even as we hear the Word, open your hearts and receive what the Lord has in store for you for this season. So stay safe, stay blessed, and enjoy the service.
It's a beautiful morning, and it's a pleasure to be able to share the Word of God with you. I would like to welcome you to this service for today, for this Sunday. We welcome, especially for those that are watching us through live streaming and also on YouTube. We pray that the Word of the Lord will also bless you and help you. As we are preaching and sharing this Word, I believe that this Word is for me, is for you, is for everyone else. The title of my message today is The Word of God. And so we will not waste time as we go into the Word of God, as we open in a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning that our ears are circumcised, O God, to the voice of God. Lord, thank you that our ears, my God, are hearing what the Word of God says. Father, we open our hearts, we open our ears. We thank you, Father, that, Lord, you give us this Word that will speak to us, O God. Speak to our lives, O God, and be real, Father, as we minister this morning, O God. And so we give you glory, we give you honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. A friend of mine was just telling me earlier on, and they sent a message on WhatsApp, and this was about the King Saul, and that is King Saul went out to look for donkeys, and while he was looking for donkeys, the prophet came and anointed him king while he was still looking for donkeys. And so when he went back, and his uncle asked him, what were you doing? And he said, no, we're just gone to look for donkeys. And what did you tell the prophet? We told him we were looking for donkeys. You know, this is very interesting, because while other people are busy with serious business of the kingdom, others are still doing the donkey work, just looking for donkeys, things that are mundane, things that do not matter. But the crux of the matter is that King Saul was being ordained King Saul during that time. But other people are busy doing things that really do not add value into the kingdom of God. But this time around, we find out that King Saul was looking for kingdom things, and this was about the kingdom of the children of Israel. And so this morning, let's be very careful that we are not looking for donkeys only, but we are looking for the kingdom of God, and that we are looking for things that bring reality to our lives. And so this morning, as we are going to look into the Word of God is not seasonal. The Word of God is not something that we start today and tomorrow we are off it. The Word of God is consistent and constant, and should be in our mouths, should be in our hearts, should be in our spirits each and every time of our lives. That's why we are also encouraged to be ready in season and out of season. So the Word of God has no planting, has no harvest, and that we give up, we stop looking at the Word of God. The Word of God is consistent, and we need to immerse ourselves. We need to get ourselves endowed into the Word of God. And so this morning, I'm just going to ask you, what starts your day? What kickstarts your day as a person? What is it that you look into that you will say to yourself, this is me? In the morning when you wake up, what's the first thing that you do? What are your priorities? Is WhatsApp your priority? Is TV your priority? Is chatting to other people a priority? Or your priority is not to look after donkeys, but kingdom mentality? Is your priority to look into the Word of God and begin your day by praying? And begin by looking at what God says for your life? Because when you make the right priority, then everything else about your life, about that day, is going to just flow out as you minister to God. And so this morning, I just want you to look As we look into the Word of God, in the beginning, right from the beginning, what do we see right up to the end of Scriptures? Is God speaking or does God just keep quiet throughout? There's times that God has kept quiet from the children of Israel and it was because of the disobedience. And the same thing can be said of us. Are we going to keep quiet and is God going to keep quiet in our lives because we are not aligning ourselves to the kingdom of God? And that is not going to happen. So in the beginning, what happened? The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Amen. So we see that God, right from the beginning of creation, has been speaking. Right at the beginning, God created, and He was creating by saying things, by saying, let there be, let there be, let there be, and those things were so. And so even in your life, how do you begin your day? Do you begin your day by speaking those things for them to come to fruition? Do you speak to your day? Do you prophesy to your day? Do you speak about those things that you desire God to come and do in your life? So in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, but the creation of the heaven and the earth was because God spoke. So the spoken word is very important. It should be first things first. Those are the things that we must look into. The Bible also goes on to tell us in John chapter 1 verse 1 that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. We know that it was speaking about Jesus. We know that at the beginning, at the foundations, there was God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. The three began to speak among themselves. Let us form man up to our own similitude. Let's make man in our own image. And so they were speaking the Word of God. And so in John chapter 1 verse 1, it tells us that in the beginning, right from the foundations, what are your foundations in your life? What is it that comes up when you are tried and tested? Is the Word of God speaking in your life? Is the Word of God full of power and being creative in your life? There are so many things in our lives that we need to create by our mouths. So many times we've allowed other people to create and say things about ourselves. But what do we say to ourselves? What does the Word of God say right at the beginning of your life, right at the beginning of the morning or the night? What it is that God is saying to you? What it is that God is speaking to you? Because we need to hear, we need to understand and appreciate the Word of God. So the spoken word went out to create right in the beginning. And right now the Bible tells us in John chapter 1 verse 1 that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So Jesus was right at the foundation. Whatever then Jesus comes and speaks right in through the New Testament is nothing new, but it's things that they spoke about right at the beginning, right in the foundations. God spoke and came and lived through men, became flesh like us, like you and me, so that He could understand, He could have the same feelings that you and I do have. And so when you have had the same feelings, do you still declare things? Do you still create things? Do you still have the Word of God in you, shut up in your bones, beginning to then exude within your spirit, within yourself, the Word of God? So in the morning, pump yourself with the Word of God, child of God. Pump yourself with the Word of God, the spoken word, and also the read word, and also the seen word. What is it that you are looking for? It is all found in the Word of God. Do not start your morning in a sullen attitude. Do not start your morning without speaking the Word of God. Do not start your day without speaking to your Father. How do you speak to your Father? You read in the Word. You understand the Word of God. What is it that the Word of God is saying in your life? What is it that the Word of God is saying in my life? So make first things first. Just as much as you wash your body in the flesh in the morning, wash your spirit first in the morning through the Word of God. You will not stink in the midst of people. You will produce a sweet aroma. You will produce an aroma that draws people to you. Just as much as we wake up early in the morning, especially on the ladies' side, I know we want to go onto that mirror, make sure that we are looking well, make sure that we are looking immaculate, make sure that you are looking stunning. But what is it that we do with the spiritual body? How do we take care of the spiritual body in the morning before we leave our houses? So it is incumbent, it is important for you and I not just to wash and adorn the physical body, but to also make sure that the spiritual man is fed by the word of God. The spirit of man is not fed by anything else but the things of the spirit. And the things of the spirit start from the word of God. So allow the word of God to speak to you. Allow the word of God to minister to you. Allow the word of God to be with you right from the beginning. Make sure that when you have heard the word of God, when the word of God begin to well off from you, all these things become easy to go through. In the morning, you clean yourself up. You go out, you are smelling nice. You are able to, you appreciate, to interact with all the other people. But if you have not bathed yourself, if you have not made yourself presentable and clean before other men, it's going to be difficult for you to interact with other people that you're going to see for that day. People will be sniffing off their nose because of the stench that comes from you. But when you are clean, when you are sweet, there's that appreciation and an attraction. The word of God does attract people to you. When the word of God, when you are full of the word of God, people are attracted. They do not have any other reason. They cannot run away from you, but they will be drawn to you because you are drawn to the word of God. The word of God is so, so, so sweet. The word of God is so, so attractive. It draws men to you just as much as Jesus. Not so much of any other day that Jesus walked on his paths without people being attracted to him, because he was the word. The throngs, the many people, the crowds that came to Jesus, it's because Jesus attracted men, because he is the word, because he was the word from the foundations right up to now, up to when he comes back, when he comes through the clouds, when we shall see him. You and I shall see him as he comes through the clouds, as he witnesses his coming back, his second coming. But Jesus attracted crowds. Do you attract people to yourself? Jesus attracted because he is God. He is the word. He is the fullness of the word of God. That's why he was able to attract people to himself. Jesus attracted because of the word of God. He attracted all manner of, could they've been prostitutes, people that cheated, the tax collectors, fishermen, everyone, kings, even the centurion himself was attracted to Jesus. So he attracted all manner of men to himself because of the word of God. And so, as I said, that in the beginning there was creation, which was our number one point. And so we look at our number two point. The beginning is followed by creative power of the word of God. Amen. Situations are created by the word of God. Create the atmosphere before your day begins. Prophesy to the word. Prophesy to the day that is before you. So when you prophesy, you speak to what is before you. You speak to those things that be not as though they are. Amen. You need to look at all those in the context of the word of God. What does the word of God say to you? What is it that God is speaking to you about? So those are some of the things that you need to look at and be able to prophesy on those days. Amen. In Job chapter 38 verse 12, we know what it says. Speak to your day. Speak to your day before you go anywhere. Make sure that you speak those things that you want to see in the day, because if you do not, someone else is going to speak into your day. Some other voices are already speaking into your day. But when you have the word of God, when you have immersed yourself in the word of God, you are able to prophesy and speak to your day. You are able to align your day to the word of God. You are able to align your day to what God wants you to do. Because we all don't know what God wants us to achieve and accomplish for the day. But when God speaks to us, when God in that clarity of his voice comes to us through the word, it becomes easy for us. All we need to do is to appropriate and speak the word of God. When we speak the word of God, when we prophesy, like we said, the word of God, as in Job chapter 38, we are speaking those things that be not as though they are. Amen. You are beginning to shape up your day, beginning to speak to those situations in your day, because you do not know who you are going to meet during the day. You do not know who you are going to meet when you are just walking around throughout the day. But when you begin to prophesy upon your day, it becomes much and much more easier. So the third point this morning is that sustaining power of the word. It is the sustaining power of the word. Throughout the day, the word sustains you by the word of God. Amen. What is it that after the morning, after you have declared, you go through the day, what is it that is going to sustain you throughout the day? What is it that you are going to hold on to throughout the day? But when you begin to yield yourself to the word of God, when you begin to yield yourself to through the spirit of the Holy, the person of the Holy Spirit that leads you to the word of God, you are sustained throughout the day. You cannot fall for sin. You cannot fall into during the day because you are sustained by the word of God. The word of God is able to carry you throughout. Okay, as we know what Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, it says, this book of the law shall not depart out of their mouth. You shall meditate upon it day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. When you have meditated upon the word of God during the day, you will bring success to yourself. This is what the word of God tells us, that it will make your way prosperous. There's no way you can prosper your day without looking into what the word of God says. When you look into the word of God and speak matter to yourself, begin to chew like cud, like a cow does in the evening when it sits down. It's chewing its cud. It's meditating. Do the same thing as you go through. Yes, there's lots of distractions. We are all very much aware. There's lots of distractions during the day. But of course, part of that discipline is that during the day, you begin to speak to yourself scripture. You begin to tell and remind yourself of what you read about in the morning. You begin to say those things that God says you are. Because there's loads and loads of promises in the word of God. We've spoken about the promises of God before, that the promises of God are A and amen. They do not falter. They do not stop coming through for you and I. So the promises of God will be A and amen. They will not change. Only you can change. So today my challenge to you is begin to allow the word of God. Be immersed in the word of God. Be challenged to make sure that there's no day that goes without you looking into the word of God. Begin to see who God is in your life during the day. And he will surely, as he says in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, that you will make your ways prosperous. Show me a man that prays. Show me a man that reads the word of God. Show me a man that meditates upon the word of God, and I'll show you success. I'll show you a prosperous man. It's not about being prosperous only in the physical things, in the material things, but it's being prosperous in the spiritual things, because all things are spiritual. So when you become prosperous in the word of God, you will become prosperous in all these other things. Just like the word of God tells us in chapter 6 of Matthew, that seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added unto you. How do you seek the kingdom of God? The kingdom of God is found in the word of God. The kingdom of God is found in his word, in the manuals of the kingdom of God. That's the manual that we find. Amen. So meditate upon the word of God. Make sure that you are looking into what the word of God says about you, about your situation, about your family, about everyone else that you interact with. So seek ye first the kingdom of God. Read ye first the word of God, and you will have success, and you will make your way prosperous throughout the day. The enemy, yes, he will come in like a flood, but the word of God will be raised as a standard against him, and he will not touch you. Just make sure that you immerse yourself in the word of God. When Jesus was being tested and tried by the enemy after having fasted for 40 days and 40 nights on the mountain, the enemy came and tried to circumvent the word of God and tried to adulterate the word of God. But Jesus came and said, it is written. Hallelujah. It is written. That was the answer that the devil needed to hear, because Jesus was the word. Remember, Jesus was the word, all word throughout. He came and his people did not understand him, but he was full of the word. That's why even in the beginning of the ministry, when he was on the mountain being tempted by the enemy, he could resist the enemy because because of the word of God. He could resist the enemy because of what he represented, which is the word of God. So when we walk throughout the day and the enemy comes in with all sorts of things, I'm not saying that we will not falter. Yes, here and there we will, but Jesus will raise us up. Amen. The Bible says, a righteous man falls 7 times but rises up. So it is. A righteous man reads the word of God. A righteous man understands the word of God. And so when we are full of the word of God, we have a lot of liberty. We have a lot of prosperity in our lives. Show me a man that is reading the word of God and is rich in the spirit. I'll show you a man that is rich in the spirit, because we need to appreciate what the word of God stands for in our lives. So yes, we have lots of other things that we can look at, that we can watch throughout the day, things that can encourage us. But do not substitute the word of God. Never make that mistake in your life of substituting the word of God. The word of God is alive and the word of God is true. Amen. And in the fourth point that I have for you is that the word of God brings healing power. Amen. So healing power of the word of God. Healings comes from understanding what the word of God says about your illness. By his stripes, the word of God says, we are healed. Healing is the children's bread. Amen. In Isaiah chapter 53 verse 5, one of the greatest scriptures that we ever read, he says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, but by his stripes we are healed. Amen. By his stripes we are healed. If you have a relative, if you have a friend that is not feeling well, begin to speak the word of God, and the word of God will heal them. The Bible tells us that Jesus comes with healing in his wings. Hallelujah. The Son of Righteousness will come with healing in his wings. Those are the wings that will bring healing into you, because they come from the Son of God, who is the word of God. Amen. So when it comes to healing, know that the word of God, he was sent to come and give healing to us. Healing is the children's bread. Healing is not meant for the swine or for anything else. Healing is meant for the children of God, even for those that do not know him. When we pray the prayer of healing and they are healed, it becomes a testimony for them, and they begin to appreciate who God is in their life. Amen. So let us begin to make sure that we are full of the word of God. Do not be full of anything else, but be full of the word of God, because when it is translated, it brings the power to heal. Amen. So when you are laying your hands upon those that are not sick, you are speaking the word of God. Because you are full of the word of God, you can translate that word of God, which is mixed with faith, and it will bring about a miracle. In Psalms chapter 107 verse 20, the Bible tells us, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them all from their distractions. God sends his word to heal us. God sends his word to come and fulfill us. Amen. Hallelujah. He does not send his word for void, but it comes to fulfill that which was sent to do. So if the word of God is sent to you to bring about healing, it will definitely bring about healing. And that's the healing that the Son of Righteousness comes with in his wings, with healing in his wings. Amen. And our fifth point is purifying ability of the word of God. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us that in Psalms chapter 12 verse 6, the words of the Lord are pure words, like silver tried in the furnace of the earth, purified 7 times. The word of the Lord are pure words, like silver tried in the furnace of the earth, 7 times and purified. Amen. So the Bible tells us that the word of God is a purifying process. When we become before him, when we just surrender ourselves and abandon ourselves upon him, and we begin to understand and appreciate and read the word of God, we look at the word of God. What is it saying about me? Is it purifying me? Is it cleansing me? It's got this cleansing effect. It's got this purifying effect. So if there is sin in my life, I'm able to confess it, because I am basing it on what the word of God says, that confess your sins to God and he will set you free. Amen. That if you confess your sins in whatever way, God will set you free and will heal you as well. And so while you are being cleansed, once you are allowing yourself to, because when we stand before God, we are going to be purified. When we stand before God, we will be just like We have never sinned. How does someone just become like they've never sinned when they've not been cooked, when they've not been fried in the Word of God, when they've not been cleansed as a lot of burning of the dross, a lot of burning of the sin, a lot of burning of the bad habits that need to go out of us as we look into what the Word of God says. Amen. As we look into what the Word of God says, the Word of God needs to come and bring that cleansing effect upon our lives, upon our bad habits, upon the situations that we find ourselves in. So allow the Word of God to burn you. Allow the Word of God to take away the sin that is in your life. Allow the Word of God to come and cleanse you like hyssop. Hallelujah. Create in me a clean heart, David writes in Psalms chapter 51. And create in me a clean heart, O Lord, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, O Lord. And Lord, do not take away your Holy Spirit from me, because your Holy Spirit is my partner in this life. He's the one that walks with me. He's my paraclete. He is close by me. He shows me the things to come. He also leads me into reading of the Word. And not only the reading of the Word, but the understanding of the Word of God. That's the work of the Holy Spirit in my life. And so our sixth point is that the word of the Lord works in directing our paths. Amen. In directing our paths. We need our paths to be directed. We need our paths to be cleansed before us. Just like John says, I come from the wilderness. I say, prepare ye the way. Prepare ye the way of the Son of God coming through. So the Word of God is preparing us, amen, to be able to meet with Jesus when he comes for the second time. The Word of God is preparing us to make sure that we are that bride that is clean before him. We spoke about the cleaning qualities, the perfection of the Word of God, the burning, the purifying effect of the Word of God. That's what God is going to seek of us when he comes again through his Son. When Jesus comes and the trumpet is blown, it will be only for those that are pure in heart. It will be only for those that have their paths directed by Jesus. And so in Psalms chapter 119 verse 105, which we all know and we read, is your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. How can you have your paths directed if you do not have the Word of God? And so it's only the Word of God that directs our paths. It's the only the Word of God that shows us the way to go. Amen. Amen. And so we look at our seventh point. The Word of God is revealed to us by the Holy Spirit. So thy word brings light. Amen. In Psalms chapter 119, again, verse 130, it says, the entrance of your words give light. Hallelujah. The entrance of your word gives light. It gives understanding to the simple. It brings understanding to the simple. So that is the effect of the Word of God. It brings light into your situation, dark as it can be in your life, dark as it can look like. The Word of God brings light. It begins to illuminate those things in your life. It begins to shine on those things that are dark, upon those sins, upon those bad habits. The light of the Word of God begins to reveal to you what it is that you need to do. You begin to have an understanding of your day. You're beginning to have an understanding of other people that are around you, because the Word of God brings light into your life. Your path is straightened. Your path is illuminated as you go, because you begin to see yourself bare before the Lord, because he comes. Even those funny nooks, those side nooks, those corners that other people do not see, the Holy Spirit through the Word of God comes and shines upon those things, begins to reveal those things that are not right before you and God, between you and God, and begin to say, work on that brother, begin to confess that sin, begin to confess that that relationship that is not right. Because the light of God, he is the light, Jesus is the light, he comes and illuminates your path. He begins, comes and illuminates your heart, those things that you have been harboring, that jealousy, that evil, that resentment. He begins to come and illuminate it in your life. And as you see yourself bare before him, as that light shines upon your life, you begin to say, Lord, here am I. Lord, cleanse me. Lord, look into my life and begin to work into my life. Begin to make sure that I'm a clean person. Hallelujah. Because we come before the Lord and we are not clean. We are unrighteous. But the Word of God begins to work in us. The Word of God begins to work in us, begins to clean those areas in our lives that need to be cleaned, begins to reveal through His light, that brings light into our hearts, and we begin to see ourselves for who we are. There's no compromise when the Word of God comes to you. Hallelujah. There's no compromise when the Word of God hits into those areas that need to be illuminated, that need to be shone on, and we begin to say, Lord, I am sorry. Lord, cleanse me. Lord, I repent of my unrighteousness because of the Word of God that comes and begin to speak to you. The light begins to do its work. There's nothing that we cannot walk in the light and also walk in darkness, because the Word of God comes. And when we begin to read the Word of God, we are allowing that light, we are allowing that radiation to come. Just like when you go for x-ray, that light comes and shows you bare what is inside you. Those bones that we cannot see from outside, you might be so big that we cannot see the bones in there. But when that x-ray comes, it begins to examine those little things, that begins to examine and look into those small details in your life. And when that light comes, you allow yourself, as you yield yourself to that light, and you allow God and ask God to forgive you and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Amen. And so praying the Word of God is our number 8 point. So pray the Word of God. Declare the Word of God. Prayer. Through prayer. One powerful type of prayer is praying the Word of God. Amen. So there's other things that you can pray to. There are other things that you can talk about. There's things that you can worship, yes, but also do not give away praying the Word of God. This something amazing about declaring the Word of God. When you begin to declare of what God says, who you are, what the situation is, but God, through His Word, when you begin to pray and say, Lord, I thank you for this situation. Lord, I bless you for this situation. Lord, thank you for this relationship. It will be healed. Thank you, Father, for this sickness. It will be healed. Father, your Word, doesn't it say, remind God of what His Word says. Begin to tell God what He says through His Word. When he is reminded of his word, God has no choice but to come down and begin to act on your behalf. The angels begin to be busy working on your behalf, because the Bible says they are ministering angels, they are ministering agents. They come to begin to shift things, even those that hate you, because the Word of God is spoken. Even those that speak ill of you, because the Word of God is being spoken, they begin to shift. Situations begin to shift. Situations begin to change around. There's a turnaround in your life. There's a turnaround in your life because the Word is being spoken. Wake up in the morning, child of God. Upon going down to your bed, begin to declare, speak the Word of God. Speak the Word of God upon your life. Speak the Word of God upon your children. Speak the Word of God upon your wife, upon your siblings, upon anyone else. Declare the Word of God. Declare what the Word of God says about their lives, about them, because then God begins to act on your behalf. Hallelujah. God is not moved by tears. God is not moved by your emotions. God is not moved by your crying. God is moved by your faith and your faith in the Word of God. Hallelujah. So begin to realize that without faith, we cannot do anything. Without faith, without the Word of God, we cannot accomplish anything. So allow the Word of God to immerse you. Allow the Word of God to immerse you. So just a few days ago, I was just reading on our morning devotion in church, and that leads me to our ninth point, which is the fact that the Word of God is spirit and life. Hallelujah. In John 6, verse 63, the Bible reads, "The words that I have spoken to you, they are spirit and they are life." The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and they are life. Whenever the Word of God is released, hallelujah, it releases life. Whenever the Word of God is released upon our lives, it releases life. Life in its abundance. Life that we can hold on to. Life that you and I can begin to enjoy, because the Bible tells us that when Jesus gives us life, He gives us more abundantly. Hallelujah. It's not in half measures, but we enjoy life because of the Word of God. That's why Jesus says, "The life that I give to you is eternal, is abundant." Amen. Because Jesus is the Word. So the Word is able to do that in your life. So whenever the Word is released, there is life. Whenever the Word of God is released, there is life. Amen. Whenever the Word of God enters the human being, That person begins to show spiritual life. Amen. You cannot show spiritual life without the Word of God. So you need the Word of God to work in you. I must be in a place where the Word can flow through me without fail. Hallelujah. Allow the Word of God to flow through you throughout the day, throughout your situations. Do not allow the Word of God to be dormant. Do not allow the Word of God to be stagnant. Hallelujah. Activate it. Make sure that that spiritual life, that flow, that Word of God is flowing through you without fail. Amen. Meditate upon it day and night. That's why it says in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, meditate upon the Word of God. When I stop this flow by disobedience, pride or perverseness, that moment life stops. Amen. When I stop giving heed to the Word of God, life stops. Hallelujah. Growth stops. So I stop functioning in the way that God wants me to. And so outwardly, the Pharisees obeyed every rite and tradition, but because the word had stopped flowing through them, that's why Jesus said they are like tombs, empty tombs, white tombs. Amen. So because outside, like I said, outside they were clean. They looked very smart. They looked nicer with their robes. But inside, the word of God did not dwell upon them. They spoke things from outside. They did not speak things from the inside, from their hearts. And so the word of God was not part of them. The word of God was not in them. So make sure that as much as we want to clean ourselves outside, make sure that the inside is also clean as well. Just as we mentioned in our first point, that clean up, allow yourself to be cleaned by the word of God when you wake up in the morning. So my relationship with Jesus' words determines whether I am a minister of life or a minister of death. Amen. So I can minister life or I can minister death through the words that I say. So death and life are in the power of the tongue. And so what I declare with my tongue is what will bring life. Amen. And of course, our 10th point today is that the word of God is a mirror. We've already spoken about how we should mirror ourselves in the word of God. James chapter 1 verse 24 tells us, "For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he is. But whoso looketh into the perfect law which is the word of God, the perfect law of liberty, and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word, this man shall be blessed in his deed." Amen. So we are blessed indeed when we begin to mirror ourselves in the word of God. Look at yourself. Do not be shy. Allow the word of God to mirror into you and tell you who you are. But do not just look at the word of God and quickly go and forget about it in a few moments later. Do not forget who you are. Do not forget your identity of what the word of God says. So look at yourself in the mirror and continue with that same face that you have seen in the morning from the mirror. Amen. Allow God to mirror himself into your life. Amen. Allow God to be the person, the word of God, to be the your umpire, to be the one that referees, to be the one that looks at how your day goes. Amen. So do not allow the day to go and just go without you being the self person, the same person that you were in the morning when you were looking into your word, into the word of God, and you were praying that, "Lord, I am faithful." And then you begin to be unfaithful during the day because in the morning you have said, "I am as bold as a lion." And then a situation comes, you begin to be timid, or you have changed yourself. You have looked yourself in the mirror, but during the day you have changed. Do not change yourself, child of God. Do not change yourself, child of God. Continue to be who you are. Amen. And our last point today, hallelujah, Ezekiel chapter 37 from verse 1 to 5. The word of God speaks to dry bones. The word of God speaks to dry bones. And so as I read Ezekiel chapter 37, it says the first verse, "The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry." Not just many, but dry as well. "And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, and I said, Lord, if you want, and thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord." Hallelujah. Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. That says the Lord our God unto these bones, "Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you and ye shall live. Remember what we read in our ninth point, that allow the words of God are spirit and life. So God is spirit and life. And so the words, when they are spoken into dry bones, hallelujah, they begin to shake. The bones do not live there where they are before the word of God is spoken. They start to live. They begin to come together. All your things will work together according to Romans chapter 8 verse 28, because you love God, because you are called according to his purposes, because the word of God dwells in you. So all things do not work together if you do not work together with the word of God, if you do not work together with Jesus Christ. But of course, when you begin to speak to those dry situations, when we begin to prophesy upon those dry relationships, upon those dry financial situations in your life, when you begin to speak the word of God, the Bible says the breath and the life of God will be in it. Hallelujah. The dry bones will begin to hear the word of God. Dry bones do not listen to your tears. Dry bones do not listen to your cry. But dry bones listen to the word of God. So speak to those dry bones in your place, even in your country, in your city, wherever you are, wherever you are watching us from, begin to pray for the prosperity of that city. As Jeremiah chapter 7 says, that pray for the prosperity of that city. And when that city is prospering, you will also prosper. Because when that word of God begins to be exercised in those situations, if you have no job, begin to speak to that situation and say, job, dry bones of Job, begin to come together, begin to come to life. Whatever situation you have in your life, I do not know and I might not understand where you are at in your life, but the word of God tells me that when you speak to the dry bones, they begin to listen. When you have not been married and it's looking like it's too late, begin to speak to those dry bones. Begin to speak to the dry bones of barrenness as well, because God is a God of life. Ask him that, Lord, take away my shame, because your word tells me that there's no more barrenness in Israel. There's no more barrenness in my life. Could it be the spiritual barrenness? Could it be the physical barrenness? Speak into those situations. Begin to prophesy and speak to those situations and allow those dry bones to live again. Allow those dry bones in your life to live again, because the word of God has spoken to them, and because the word of God has come out to them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Begin to speak to those situations. Allow the word of God to work in you. Allow the word of God to work in you. The word of God is spirit and life. Hallelujah. The word of God is spirit and life. So if you desire life in your life, begin to allow the word of God. Immerse yourself in the word of God. Meditate upon it day and night. Let it not depart from you. How can a young man cleanse his ways but by taking heed to the word of God, by making sure he reads the word of God? How can a young woman make their way clean but by taking heed to the word of God? What is it that the word of God says about your situation today? Give it up to Jesus. Surrender it all to Jesus. Because Jesus, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And Jesus is part of the Trinity, and Jesus is the Word of God. So today, I want to pray that God blesses you with this Word. But don't just listen to it, but go and take action. Go and utilize it. Go and work it in your life. Allow the word of God to speak in your life. Allow the word of God to rule in your life. Do not make other things become a priority. First things first. Whenever you wake up in the morning, begin to meditate, speak to yourself, speak to your situations, speak to those dry bones, and they will come and live again. So Heavenly Father, this morning I just thank you for your children, for your people. Lord, I pray for those that, my God, were reaching us out, oh God, on, my God, Father, Lord, on our media, oh God, various medias. I pray that, Jehovah, those that were live streaming with us, bless them, oh God. Bless them with this word, oh God. And let the word work for them, oh God. In the mighty and precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Oh,